And arraha here is the wording of arraha. But here to find joy, to find rest, to find this calmness in the salah. طيب, so therefore, alhamdulillah, entering the salah, all of those we got to cultivate that in us, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. And any, not only restricted to the salah, but in every single type of act of worship that we do. And he say, وَتَطْمَئِنَّ إِلَىٰ ta'atihi subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also you will find calmness into that which is worship, the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, you having you are eager in desiring that which barakallahu fikum is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he say that this is indeed the tariqah, the pathway or the way of those who are the muhsineen, those who are the people of ihsan. May Allah make me and make you all, wal mustami'ina wal mustami'at, to be among those who are the muhsineen. Inshallah ta'ala, our next class, next week, we'll be mentioning about the martaba al-thaniya, the second level or the second degree in regard to al-ihsan. We suffice ourselves with this, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us our sins and to guide us to what is correct and to make our feet firm upon the sunnah. Walhamdulillah, as Imam Ahmad rahimahullah used to heard a person say, alhamdulillah al-islam, and he added, was sunnah. We were all upon Islam. Right? All of us here were upon Islam. Right? But there was a great matter that was missing in our lives. The sunnah. But alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are striving, even with their shortcomings, to be striving to be upon the sunnah. May Allah make us die upon the sunnah. Ameen. And make us die in the mix of the people of the sunnah. That's very important. May the people of the sunnah be the one to witness our janazah. May the people of the sunnah be the one to put us in our grave. You don't want nobody or somebody, man, with all amulets putting in your grave. Do you? I don't. Let everybody mention one thing from the class and we close it out tonight. Now, as in regard to the Qadr, the people, they divide into three categories: the Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the Qadariya, and the Jabariya. Naam. The Jabariya, they believe that the servant is being forced. Amar. I forgot you got bad eyes. I'm looking at you, but. Huh? Ihsan has one pillar. Ihsan to Hassan. Very good. Between the servant and Allah. Naam, Abu Bakr. Akhi, no man. Okay. Say it one more time, I'm sorry. Abdullah, please cut it off. Sit right here. Say it one more time. So you leave from America to Spain. That's what you say, ain't it?
No, from Makkah to Medina.
Hijrah is you move from Makkah to Medina. If a person move from Makkah to... There is no hijrah from Makkah to Medina now. Because there's a hadith that is clear. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, as our brother just mumbled it, that la hijrata ba'da al-fath, that there is no hijrah after the conquest of Makkah. Now have ihsan in your answer, akhi. Right? That's the third category of ihsan, is the person performing what he's performing in the best way possible. So have ihsan in your answer, akhi, inshallah. Rectify your answer. Perfect it. So hijrah is? Moving from the? Right? To where? To what land?
The land of believers.
Ahsanta, very good. Barakallahu fiqh. Okay, for what purpose? To marry a woman?
In order to safeguard your deen.
Ahsanta. Abu Zur'a. الناس. أيوة.
نعم الحسنى الحسنى هناك جنة.
الحسنى جنة.
نعم. الزيادة أن يرى إلى الله.
النظر إلى. من الذي سبقك على هذا؟
من الذي سبق على هذا؟
سبقك على هذا. Who preceded you in the statement? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Simple. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the one that explained this verse. Right? I ask who preceded you in this? Say the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the one that gave the tafsir of this verse. Na'am, ihsan. Very good. The second category of ihsan is between the servant and the human being. Naam, tunkara. Inna. Kulla shay'an. Naam. So that's a dalil for what? Huh? That's the dalil for what? Inna kulla shay'an. Based on a divine decree. Naam, ahsanta, Muhammad. Ahsanta, iman is actions of the heart, statement of the tongue, action of the body, limbs. Statement of the heart increases with act of obedience and decreases with act of disobedience. Huh? Yeah, it is action of the heart and statement of the heart, both of them. Abdullah.
أن الله سبحانه وتعالى لا يرى في الدنيا ولكنه يرى في الآخرة ويراه أهل الإيمان.
أحسنت. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not to be seen in this life, but He will be seen يوم القيامة and only by the people of al-Iman. Now, if the seeing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a reward, a recompense, a delightful matter, then what we will call al-mafhum al-mukhalafa is that not seeing Allah yawm al-qiyamah itself is a punishment. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that the disbelievers, they will be what? They will be mahjubun. They will be screened from seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that, if that's the case, then it's not going to be the same for the believers. And all of this are adilla in regard to seeing Allah subhanahu yawm al-qiyam. Aba Ibrahim. That ihsan between the servant and his Lord. Uh-huh. And this is, when we say al-ihsan, this is what we meant. Abdullah. أن تعبد الله كأنك. That the martaba, the first degree, is that you worship Allah as you are seeing Him. Right? Now that will be the second one, inshallah, we'll deal with next time. Na'am Abdullah. Na'am, iman has 70 some odd branches. 70 some odd branches. Which one is the lowest? Take something. Take something. Very good. Very good. Take something harmful away from the pathway of the people. Abu Shay.
The proof of six pillars is in
أن تولوا قبل ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب. Revise that verse for next time. The highest level of La ilaha illallah is the highest level of Iman is statement of La ilaha illallah. Abu, speak louder so they can hear you. Speak a little louder, please. If there is shirk, that means there is no Islam. If there is shirk, it means that there is no Islam. Because we were talking about the four things that will make the Islam of the person to stand. If there was any mistake that I have done, please rectify. The Qadariya, they deny the Qadr. Right. Alladhina yanfawna al-Qadr. Right. And you have the Jabariya. The Jabariya, they are those who, barakallahu fikum, they believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he forced the person. So the Jabariya, they believe that the servant, right, doesn't have no will. Amma the Qadariya, they say the will, Allah is in the, Allah doesn't have none to do with the action of the servant. Allah's will doesn't have none to do with the action of the servant. But he doesn't even know the action of the servant until the servant do the action. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this gathering a gathering that he is pleased and happy with. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention each of every one of us name in his gathering with the angels, I mean. Allah yabarak fi. Naam. لا الإحسان في الشرع بارك الله فيكم هذا في لما قال إحسان بين العبد وربه فهذا في الشرع ولكن الإحسان على الإطلاق في اللغة بمعنى بارك الله فيكم يعني أن تكم الصيغة الكمال في شيء يعني حيثما تعمل يعني تكمل العمل حتى بارك الله فيكم صار يعني تماما يعني بالجميل وما أشبه ذلك. So he was asking that here the Shaykh Hafidhahullah he mentioned about the ihsan in the language. Where he mentioned, if you all remember, he say, it is itqanu shay, meaning perfecting something. Because remember, barakallahu fikum, the other hadith, inna allaha kataba al-ihsan la fi kulli shay. That Allah has decreed, legislated ihsan in everything. And then he start mentioning فَإِذَا ذَبَحْتُمْ فَأَحْسِنُوا إِشْ الذِّبْحِ وَإِذَا قَتَلْتُمْ فَأَحْسِنُوا الْقِتْلِ. Right? Allah has prescribed ihsan in everything. Even if when you are killing, perfect the killing. If you are slaughtering, perfect the way you are slaughtering it. Meaning make it in the most efficient way. فَلْيُرِحْ ذَبِحَتُهُ. Let him make it easy upon his animal. Let him not make the animal suffer. Now you're taking a knife that is dull, so dull that it can't even cut through a butter. Now you want to slaughter an animal with that? Well, you're going to be spending 15 minutes on the neck of the animal or on the throat of the animal. Like you're exercising or you're sharpening the knife on the throat of the animal. Are you being having ihsan? No, you aren't. You're not. But rather, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he say how to have ihsan when one slaughter. He say two things. He say number one, make your blade to be very sharp. Number two, do it quickly, very quickly, to the point that you will, alhamdulillah, ease up. Right? You will ease up the slaughtering of the animal. Likewise, when a person is killing. Don't be like a barbarian person when a person is killing. Right? Huh? It could be anything. For instance, if the hakim, the ruler, if there is somebody that kills somebody, mathalan, and then the ruler, we say the ruler, decide that this individual, yes, it is being found that he killed so and so. So he has to be killed. Let's say the ruler say this. Even in that killing of that person, that criminal, it has to be done with ihsan. You can't torture.